are amongst the most backward, with the exclusion of Turkey. They're amongst the most repressive and horrible regimes, not just in the Middle East, but the world. Saudi Arabia, they hang people, flog people, and behead people as part of the state policy. I mean, literally, on average, 20 people a month get beheaded in Saudi Arabia through the court system. So, you know, those are our allies in a fight against barbarism. Once you start to think about, look at that, you start to realise actually there's something else going on. What they're really doing, in my opinion, is the reason why US and Britain and the other EU countries that are involved, is because they are involved in this ongoing process of trying to restore and reinforce Western control in the Middle East because of the oil. And no doubt we'll hear more of this going down the line. But I mean, you know, with those allies, it's difficult to see that there can be any humanitarian purpose. So you have to look beneath the surface and think. I mean, one of the things that really rocked the Western powers was the Arab Spring, was what happened in Egypt, what happened in Tunisia, and then started to spread across the region. And by the way, when they talk about being pro-democracy in the Middle East, the West, the British, the Americans, they supported Mubarak, the president of Egypt, until the day he was deposed by the mass movement. During the days when Mubarak's regime was killing people in the street, 500 Egyptians were killed during that period when they got rid of him. The West supported them. The West armed Mubarak. They gave them guns. They said nothing, or they said a few words in public, but they were on board with crushing the democracy movement in Egypt. So don't let them tell us all of a sudden they're concerned about the people of the Middle East. So that's the broader thing. And then just two other points. We also need to take on the idea that somehow this whole process is going to stop the rise of fundamentalism. That actually, even in their own terms, even if you took them at their word, that what they're interested in doing is stopping ISIS, bombing would be mad, is mad. Because ISIS are going around saying, you know, the West are barbarians, they're animals, they're trying to occupy our countries, they're trying to kill people, you know, let's see how they respond. And the West falls into the trap and starts bombing Iraqis again. And of course, what ISIS will be doing now will be saying to people, we told you, look at these people, all they can do and all they've done for the last 13 years and actually for the last centuries, all they've done in the Middle East is occupy militarily and kill people. So do you think that killing, particularly Sunni Iraqis, because the ISIS are based in the Sunni communities, killing Sunni Iraqis by aerial bombardment is going to do anything other than reinforce ISIS's support, you know, reinforce the argument that people have got to take up arms against the West, and actually make the Western-backed regime in Baghdad much, much weakened. So even if you want to look at the simple thing about stopping terrorism, this is crazed. And the proof of that, in a wider sense, is that the war in 2001 was launched against apparently terrorism. At the time, Al-Qaeda existed in Pakistan and maybe bits of Afghanistan and Central Asia. Look at the map now. Al-Qaeda and similar groups have spread from that part of the world in Central Asia across the Middle East. There was no terrorist or Al-Qaeda organizations in Iraq before the war, none whatsoever. It didn't exist. Now in Iraq, in Syria, in Jordan, going south, across North Africa, parts of West Africa, Central Africa, East Africa, Al-Qaeda exists. In other words, the war on terror has done exactly 180% degrees the opposite of what they said it was supposed to do. It spread terrorism, it spread the anger, it spread bitterness, and it spread violence. And so even in their terms, this is absolutely crazy, which again is a clue that maybe there's some other agenda going on. Final point. And obviously people raise questions and stuff. Final point is this.